Hello friends, welcome to Tips by Anil, and in this video we will learn basically a error once you will connect your localhost web API with Xamarin form, and at that time you will get a exception or a error message that one or more errors occurred, failed to connect to localhost 127 whatever you have your IP address, and this is the API port. So where is this API port? So here you can see the API is running, and this is the 44344 is my port. So my Xamarin form is not able to connect this. For that, we will go on this URL. I noted here and paste in browser here, and we'll download this conveyor by keyoti. Once you will download this extension, and after that you have to do some more steps. Restart your Visual Studio and open Azure and as administrator. Okay, suppose that I will stop it and I will go in tool, then your extension will appear over here. Once you will click on this, sorry, I have to run this application first. I have to run this web API first, and now I have to click on this will open you a remote URL. This will give you a remote URL API. Once you will click on this, it will open a web API. But before that, what you have to do, I have already did, as in this article suggest that you have to press window R and type wf.msc, click on OK. It will open a pop-up window, and in this pop-up window here you can see the inbound rule. You can see that inbound rules, and I created an inbound rule Anipra web API. You have to create a new inbound rule, click on new rule. Now here you can see choose port in the new dialog box. You have to choose a port, click on next button, and here you have to specify a local port. So what's your local port? Your local port is 44344. So you have to specify this port over here, click on next, click on all allow connection, as you can see over here. And click on next, and provide your name, means inbound rule name, and click on finish. So once you will do this, then you can see you have allowed this local port, you have allowed this specific local port, and make sure your specific local port should be empty. Okay, it's not occupied by another IP address. Cool. Now connect your system with your, I have connected my system with my iPhone hotspot, and now if I will open this URL in my iPhone, then the URL will be successfully open, because if I will connect another system with same hotspot, then this IP will be open in that phone also, because we have connected our phone with the same network. Okay, so now if you will run it, it's going connected again. Now, if I will use this IP address, here okay, and then it run my application again, yes, I skipped the video because application was running. Okay, now I will provide the username and password. Now click on login button. Yes, now you can see it's successfully logged in, and now I'm able to get the access token now. Okay, so I hope you like this video, and if you like this video then please subscribe my channel. And one more thing I want tell you, that if this address I will use in Postman, here then also it will give us the output. Look. Okay, so thanks for watching my video. Have a nice day. Bye bye.